Students, last class we deal with LED and LCD, the type of optoelectronic devices. Now today's class we'll see about photoconductors. Now these are the materials which can modulate the light falling on them. They can modulate the light which is falling on them. Now look at the name, photoconductors. In another way I can say them as photoconducting materials. So now look at the name, all the phenomena exist within the title. The materials which starts its conductivity when the light is falling on the material is called as photoconducting materials, and this effect is called as a photoconductive effect, and this phenomena is called as photoconductivity. Now once again back, we'll write the materials conductivity increases as light falls on them. It's called as photoconducting materials or photoconductors, and hence the phenomena is called as a, this type of materials, they exhibit the phenomena, that phenomena is called as photoconductivity. Now photoconductivity is a very important phenomena. We are going to look at for photodiode. These are the topics being covered in your syllabus: photodiode, pin diode, and solar cell. So photoconductivity is a phenomena which is very common to photodiode, pin diode, solar cell, and one more is pin transistor, right? Now we will explain the photoconductivity phenomena by means of energy level diagram. As we are very familiar with energy level diagram, whose lower energy level is going to be the valence band. Now let's have valence band and the conduction band, which is the higher energy level. Let me mark here as E0 and this one as E1. Now what does our phenomena says? The conductivity of the material is going to increase when the light is being falling on them. Now what we have taken as a semiconducting material, now which contains the outermost electrons. Now when it is allowed to strike with ample energy of photons, they should have a energy, higher energy, h nu. Now what happens is, we all know that they absorb the energy, they get excited, they move to the higher energy level. Is that? Hence more number of electrons will be available. Whenever number of electrons in the higher energy level increases, conductivity automatically increases. That is a factor we know already. Now look at here, as we are supplying the photons with ample energy, maximum energy, slowly what happens, the covalent bond gets broken. The covalent bonds get broken. Where come the covalent bonds? All the atoms in the semiconductors are tightly joined together by means of covalent bonds. When the energy of photon increases, covalent bonds also got broken, and more number of electrons moves to the excited state, and hence the conductivity of the semiconducting material increases. Now remember one thing, as I say that what, when the photon of maximum energy strikes, conductivity increases. Let me summarize here. As I say, the intensity of light increases, then conductivity also increases. When I say conductivity increases, what is the meaning? Resistivity or the resistance decreases. Now I'll say this. These photoconductors, they perfectly act as, this is one point. The next point is, hence photodetectors perfectly act as a resistance when the intensity of light increases. Now the same phenomena is common for photodiodes, pin diode, pin transistor, and even for solar cell. And this is also called as photovoltaic cell.